Hello and welcome to another Warframe video. In today's video, we're going to take a look at Torin and Kanan. So let's get started. So taking a look at the evolutions for the weapon. For the first evolution, you don't have to go with headshots anymore. Even the body shots count toward the Incarnon. So feel free to aim at the body, not just the head. For the second one, we have two choices, Final Fusillade or Plentiful Mayhem. Now this is a personal preference, whichever you want to go, you can go with. You can go with Mullet Shot consumes ammo directly, which will drain out your ammo quite fast, even on the Incarnon. Or you can go with the one that I went, 3+ Multishot on the last shot in the magazine. The reason I chose this was because of the increased damage on the weapon base itself. That's the reason I went with this, rather than going for the Plentiful Mayhem. This is a personal choice, so you can go with whichever one you prefer. In the third evolution, we have three options: going with Swift Deliverance for projectile speed, going with Renewed Horror, which I'll explain in just a second, and Extended Volley, which gives magazine capacity. In my opinion, the best one is to go for magazine, because projectile speed is not that good because it's a beam weapon, so it's not that much needed. And the other one is actually really good if you're using base turret itself. What it does is basically like Koa Ogres with Nightwatch Napalm. The lingering effect of that remains on the turret weapon itself. It boosts that damage on the very first shot. That's why I don't feel like for the Incarnon turret this one is necessary, so I'm going with magazine capacity. But again, if you feel like you want to go for the others, definitely feel free to do so. For the last evolution, fourth one, we have three options again: going with crit chance, going crit chance and status chance, are going with pure status chance. In my opinion, the weapon has already enough status chance that you don't need any of it at all additionally, unless you're making a build that requires you to have more status, but in my opinion, not really needed. So we're going with critical chance. So let's take a look at the builds now. So taking a look at the first build, Galvanized Chamber for Multishot, Rambane of Grinnir for faction damage, Critical Daily for crit chance, Viral Sense and Bladed Rounds for crit damage. In this one, Bladed Rounds is an optional one. You can go with Fire Rate or you can use Riven if you have that one. Galvanized Aptitude is going to act like a conditional overload for the weapon, so the more status types you have, the more damage it's going to deal. The reason we're going with Hunter Munition is because the turret has innate toxin, and since we're using cold, it gives us viral, and using Hunter Munition gives us additional damage, bypasses the armor completely on the Grinnir. That's the reason we're using Hunter Munitions as well. Vigilance supplies for ammo management, as well as giving us enhanced crits on the weapon. Primary Merciless to give us additional damage on kills. So taking a look at the second build, which is Gas, Galvanized Chamber for Multishot, Rambane of Grinnir for faction, Critical Daily for crit chance, Viral Sense and Bladed Rounds for crit damage, Hellfire instead of Cryo Rounds to get Gas. I'm replacing Hunter Munitions with Speed Trigger to get some fire rate, and of course Galvanized Aptitude for Conditional Overload. Vigilante supplies for ammo management, as well as enhancing crits. Primary Merciless for additional damage. Taking a look at the third build, Galvanized Chamber for Multishot, Rambane of Grinnir for faction damage, Critical Daily for crit chance. We're using Galvanized Scope this time to get additional crits on headshots. And this is just to have some more fun with the weapon. You can of course use something else in the slot of this one, but I'm going to have some fun with this and of course going with Galvanized Scope. Viral Sense and Bladed Rounds for crit damage, Stormbringer for electric, and Galvanized Aptitude if you're priming the enemy for condition overload. Otherwise, you can go with Hammer Shot. In all of these builds, you can just go with Hammer Shot instead of Galvanized Aptitude if you want to get more crit damage. In my opinion, it's not needed, so that's why I'm using it. Vigilante supplies for ammo management, as well as enhancing crits. Primary Merciless for additional damage. You can go with Primary Deadhead if you want as well, that is up to you. So let's see how these two builds work in the Simulacrum. So here we are in the Simulacrum to test out how these weapons work. So we're just going to shoot the body of the enemy, and it's going to give us the Incarnon charge, and we're going to activate it. I'm going to prime the enemies so we can get the conditional overload buff. A fun fact, if you're using Saturn and you activate her Toxic Lash, that is her third. Just watch this part. We basically get unlimited ammo, so that's a really fun thing. Now if you're going for the Corrosive build, we're going to focus on the headshots on this time, while we get the kills. And voila, easy crits. And again, if you activate Toxic Lash from Saturn, we get unlimited ammo. Now I'm assuming this is a bug or might be a feature, but it is really great, especially if you're using Torrid along with Saturn. So let's take a look at Steel Path now. Bye-bye. That is it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you found it useful. If you did, be sure to leave a like, share with your friends. Comment if you have any questions. Subscribe for more Warframe content. See you in the next one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.